All right, welcome back to Fixed by Doc and our off-grid project. Addie's down there getting the bonfire going to start burning off some of that brush. And Medic Jim is supposed to be on his way here in a little while to help out again. I think it's Tuesday, if I'm not mistaken. And this morning, we went off to Lowe's and picked up 4 bags of sand and 6 bags of quickcrete, and the lawn edging border stuff. This is to do just the first couple of rows of bricks where the bricks meet the street. We're not going to concrete and lay sand and concrete the entire brick driveway. Only the first few rows where it meets the street, just because that's where the hump is, and to prevent the bricks from sliding off the hump and into the ditch and going out in the street and everything, because that's where the most wear and tear is actually going to be, because it's not level ground. So we are going to we're gonna put down a little bit of sand and then the quickcrete, and then set the bricks in so that the bricks go up and over, start on the edge of the hump and go up over the hump about 2 or 3 rows past the hump going down the driveway. And that's all we're going to do right there with the concrete. The rest of the bricks are just going to set right into the ground, and then as we drive over them, any of them that like sink or anything, we can always just go back later and pull them up, put some sand down or a little gravel underneath them and put them back down. Not too worried about them sinking into the ground or anything from there to where I'm at right here. That's just to, give a little traction, and so we're not digging big ruts into the ground. That's all the bricks are for. So we're not putting in a heavy duty foundation brick driveway or anything like that. I want to be able to come through and just pull the bricks out anytime I want and move them around, or just take the bricks out altogether if I wanted to use for something else or what have you. So who knows, maybe one day I want to take the bricks out, use them to build something else and pour gravel or something like that. So we're just going to, for the majority of the driveway, it's just going to be bricks on top of dirt, nothing else. Just the main entrance right on the hump part where you go in and go over like the speed bump portion. Only that is going to have the sand and the concrete. So I know there's going to be a lot of questions and everything else. And please reserve your questions about what we're going to do and how we're going to do it, because I will show a video of us actually doing it and installing it and putting it in. We just can't do it for a few days. I don't know if the camera's gonna show, but poured down rain last night, and I have a video going up showing us driving in the rain. It's just poured and poured and poured. And it's supposed to rain again today at some point, probably this evening. That cloud right there is probably gonna dump down on us again. So we have to wait until we have at least a full day of sunshine to put the concrete down in the bricks. And then it needs about 24 hours or more for it to harden up enough so that if it does rain, it won't wash it all away. And when we do it, we'll probably put a tarp over it too, just in case. So I have done this before. This is not a first time for me. I've done it plenty of times before. What this is going to be doing is along the edge on the left and right side of the driveway where you come in. This is a 20-foot roll. We're going to put 10 feet on either side, and this is just to help hold the bricks in place and to keep any of the rain and the water from washing everything away and whatnot right there at that entrance. So basically the edging to help prevent the erosion around the brick driveway at the entrance. We only have to brick or gravel the first 10 feet from the street into our driveway. The rest of it, we don't have to do anything with. So I did acquire a whole lot more brick, and I acquired a lot more cinder block and whatnot. I have about as much brick as you saw me collect on my other videos. I've pretty much doubled that, and I just have to pick them up. They're over at the RV park, so yeah, I will eventually get those picked up and get those over here. And then Medic Jim said that he's got another person he knows that has a big truckload of bricks too that they're giving away. Or last checked, he said last checked that they were giving them away. So he's gonna find out if they still are, and then we can go over and pick those up. So we've probably got enough brick to do a good, to get a really good start on the driveway. We have enough right now to get that first 10 feet for sure. And then plenty to get well beyond that. So we're doing good. I also, this morning, last night and this morning, I managed to talk some people out of a bunch of stuff from their dark side. A dark side is where you store a bunch of equipment, and one person might call it a junkyard or a trash dump, and another person calls it treasure hunting. So, but this dark side that I acquired has a lot of good stuff. It's got some siding and PVC piping and some iron stuff and some metal pipes and cinder blocks and brick and all kinds of stuff that I'll show you later that I get. And I even got some free windows and all kinds of cool, really cool stuff. And I'll show you a video of that later and do a little walkthrough. But for now, I gotta get this stuff into my trailer before the rain comes. I got my trailer down here finally. Got it down here last night. I'll show you real quick. I got locked up to the tree. Got a heavy duty Krypton Flex cable. Got it wrapped around the tree, and then I also got the chains around the tree too, so it's double locked there. And let's see here. The ladders, when we're done with the ladders, we'll also put the ladders through those locks as well. I got my big long extension ladder out here now so that I can get high up into the trees to tie the ropes off when I need to put tension on them, or trim off the branches up there. And then now I got all my tools so I don't have to haul them around, so we can focus on getting bricks and stuff. There's Mr. Sasquatch, or Medic Jimmer anyway. So okay, so we're gonna load up the concrete into the trailer and we'll get started. Talk to you later. All right, so because I know everybody's gonna wanna know what kind of winch I have and what I'm using, here it is. It is a Warn winch, series wound power, and it's a 12 volt winch. Model number 25314, and then a bunch of other stuff on there. But it's an M8000, and it has a duty rating of 8,000 pounds, basically. So 4-ton winch, and basically it does everything I need. It's got a 5/16 inch or 8 millimeter cable, aircraft wire rope, and I don't know how long the cable is. It's quite long though. So if I had to guesstimate, I'd say 75 yards, but not quite sure exactly how long the cable is. But it's a 5/16 inch or 8 millimeter cable, or also known as a 7x19 aircraft wire. It has a free spool mode and an engaged mode, and holds 8,000 pounds. So there you have it. And it's hooked up to my Wrangler 4.0 liter Sahara Edition Jeep with a inline 6 fuel injected. Wish it were a carburetor and wish it were diesel, but you know, the gas fuel injection is quite nice for when you are on tilts and rock climbing and stuff like that. The gas fuel injection is great, but the diesel and carburetor are great for off-grid purposes and when shit hits the fan and whatnot, for alternative fuels like gasifier conversions and running rendered animal fat and stuff like that. So it depends on what you want to use it for, but this is a gas fuel injected 4.0 inline 6. So there's my Jeep, and that's what we're using it for. Alrighty, so we got these two trees down and done with. They came down pretty much without a hitch, without any difficulties. This tree right here, the chainsaw did kind of snag on it for a moment, but we just used a pry bar and unsnagged it and then dropped it, no problems. And just like you saw on the other trees with the winch and my rope, we pulled them down the way they needed to go. We dropped one down that way and one down that way. And then chainsaw chains are dull, so I gotta take them home and sharpen them up tonight. And what is this?
I was actually throwing sparks.
So we just gotta clean up this mess enough so that I can pull my Jeep out. And then we'll come back tomorrow with a good chain, and I'll clean it all up with the chain and get it all cleared out tomorrow. Pick up these logs, put them in the pile, and we got a lot done today. Yeah, I mean, we've only been here for a couple hours, but basically what we wanted to get done was knock down those two trees, which we did.
And not knock the power line down.
Without taking down the power lines, yes. And we got these center trees down here that we needed. So that's all the trees we have to take down. We won't be taking down any more trees because we got the pathway clear. So took down this bunch of trees here. And we got these trees down and that group of trees right there down. So I have 1, 2, 3 stumps I have to pull out, which isn't too bad. These little ones will come out real easy. There won't be any difficulty at all with those, and I'll pull the little ones out tomorrow. Most likely, if the weather holds, I'll come down and get 1, 2, 3, 4, I think there's 5, 6, 7 or 8 tiny stumps that I need to pull out, and I'll get those, if the weather holds up, I'll get those tomorrow. These three big ones, I'll work on them over the weekend. And, yep, now we gotta go stack all these logs that Mr. Jim cut up today from the trees that we knocked down right here. So, okay. Addie's down there. She's burned up all that brush you saw piled up there earlier. And show you a quick look at what our log stack is right now. We're gonna throw a tarp over the, this big pile here is the dead down seasoned wood. So we're gonna toss the tarp over that. And then this wood pile here, we're just gonna leave it open to the environment for a little while because we got all that wood up there, we got a stack on it. So, okie dokie, that's where we're at right now. Alrighty, so we are pretty much done for the day. We are closing up shop. Storm's rolling in. And we are basically done with the front entrance way with everything we need to do. Addie, get Ralph. And all we need to do now is level this out, really. Fill in any of the dips and crevices. And then we can start laying brick here. And
Kyle, we didn't forget you.
We need to, as we enter the driveway, this week we need to work on removing this big tree stump or cluster of tree stump. And then get all this debris out. So we'll build a big bonfire probably right here in the center, right here.
Wow.
And after we finish logging up all this right here, then we'll and we get out whatever wood in here that we can salvage for firewood, then the rest of all that will be debris and go in the debris bonfire right here. Coming down through here, the rest of this week, we'll be focused also on removing all these little stumps. We got one right there, and we got this little stump here and this stump here. And all these little stumps there. We might have enough room right in this area. Take out this little scraggly tree right there for the truck to come in this way and go around and go there. So it's just a tiny little turn. I don't know if you're going to see it on the camera, but it's just like a tiny little turn, not really even that big at all. The truck should be able to come in and fit right in. So we probably won't even have to rip that stump out at all. We're just going to clean it up and make it look nice and just leave it there. But these little ones here will have to come out. And this one right here has to come out as well. So we'll work on getting those out for the rest of the week, probably into the weekend. And come down and show you what we got in for our firewood. And there's our burn pit. Ralphie, watch out, that's still hot. And so we're letting our fire pit burn down and die off right now. So here's our firewood. It's a lot. It is. Addie, go stand by it.
Shoulder height, because I won't pack any higher.
I want to go up to my shoulder height, but Addie won't let me. She said her shoulder height.
Stacked over my head.
So it is up to Addie's shoulder. And so we got two walls, and this wall here is about 20 feet long, and the other wall is about 12 feet long. So technically, if you squared this off, that's the size of our cabin, actually. So
it looks really small and log.
Yeah, but anyways, we got these.
Ralph, that is not a watermelon.
I think these are cherry, and they have they're full of sap. And we're saving these off to the side for smoking or whatever, some meats and stuff. Or on those days when we just can't get a fire started because they're stubborn. All the sap and stuff that's in those knots there will light up real nice.
Cherry bark is the new birch bark for me. Not as good, but...
What are you using these sticks here for, Addie?
I'm keeping those for when we need tinder, campfire wood, whatever.
Okay, so this is Addie's campfire wood bundle here.
They were conveniently that size when I found them.
So that is heat the house wood, and this is Addie's campfire wood.
Like for the wood, yeah. Or the water heater thing. Instead of sticking good logs in there, we don't need to burn it that long. We can just use smaller stuff.
Yeah. And then we have started a third stack, which is about 20 feet long as well. And we'll go up shoulder height, and that's right here. So this is our new stack of wood right there, and we still have what's left of the trees that we took down, and we have still a dozen or so dead down trees already, trees that we did not take down, trees that nature took down on its own, the ones that are scattered throughout the woods that have fallen down over time and whatnot, or deadfalls and stuff. We still got to cut those and chop those down. So what we have left from the trees that we took down today, there's some there that we got to finish logging. And what's up there, we got to finish logging. Once those are logged and stacked up here, then we will start working on the ones that are already dead and down and finish stacking those up here too. Yeah, Ralph will come over here and steal a log either off the stack or out of the pile where we're cutting them and bury them somewhere randomly. He buried one out behind the cabin today.
Did you see him, like, coveting those logs over there when I told him to look at it like a wine rack?
He buried one out over here behind the fence line, and he buried one over here behind the cabin area. So all these green poles you see here with the pink flags on them, I put in the fence posts today. For everything all the way around except for where the cabin goes. Where the orange flags are, that is marking off the rest of the area. I didn't put in any fence posts along here because the truck still has to come in here to drop the cabin off. Once the cabin's off, then I'll put in the rest of the fence posts. But sometime this week, I'll bring in the fencing and I'll at least get it fenced from here. And around these poles here, and it goes all the way down along the creek line there. Bring you over here so you can see. So at least this area of the fencing will come in. It'll come all the way down here, around that cherry tree there. And that cherry tree will be used as a fence post. It'll come around here behind this big tree. And along here. And we'll continue the fence all the way over to this corner here. I just got to get the, I need 1, 2, 3, 4 more fence posts here, and I can finish off this corner right here. But the 4 fence posts are currently being the markers for the cabin right now. So what I'll do later this week is I'll pull those fence posts out and replace them with, I'll actually mark the cabin area out better with the flags. So I can move those 4 fence posts out, finish off the fence line here, and then I'll actually bring in the fence and put the fence up. Because this fence sign out here won't affect the ability of bringing in the cabin. This week also, we're bringing in the water tanks. So, and we're going out to the grand announcement. We're going out sometime this week, either tomorrow or the next day or Friday, Wednesday, Thursday, or Friday. Don't know exactly when, but I'll let y'all know. We're going out to Slippery Rock to the, what's the name of the place? Ken's Storage, I think is the name of the place, but we'll get you the exact name when we go out there to look into ordering the cabin. So we're going to go in, check it out, get the exact details and cost for down payment and everything, because Addie's parents are going to be helping us with the down payment on the cabin. So we need to go and find out the exact costs of what they're going to want down. And then I know it's the first month and last month's payment that they want up front. So we're just going to find out exactly what that's going to be and what our monthly payments are going to be. And then we'll order it. So hopefully by, if we order it this week, it'll be 3 to 4 weeks. So we'll count on 4 weeks. If today is the 13th, is that right, Addie?
I have no clue.
I think today is the 13th, which means the cabin could be here as early as the 13th of September, if we're lucky. So, well, that's if we ordered it today, but the week of the 13th in September is when the cabin could be here at the earliest. So, alrighty, that is today's update. You'll probably actually be viewing this sometime tomorrow evening, because it'll take me all night tonight to edit it and get it processed. And then I have really slow internet, if y'all haven't noticed. I used to have super fast internet where I could upload a 5 gigabyte video would upload in like an hour and a half. Down here, a 1 gigabyte video uploads in like 6 hours.
If the power doesn't go out.
So right now over at the RV park, the power's gone out twice in the last 2 weeks.
Well, hopefully they have it fixed, because it was the same thing both times.
Yeah.
Exploding transformers.
Yeah. So, alrighty. Once we're out here, we won't have the issue of power going out. We'll just have the issue of whether or not the internet functions. So.
Oh, geez. We got to call them too.
Yeah. So we plan on being out here, not this week, but by the end of next week, we plan on living out here in the RV. So we got about a week and a half to go. Hopefully by the end of next week, we'll be out here living 100% off-grid in the RV, or as Addie calls it, the Curious Pickle. So we're only 1 week behind getting the RV out here. So, and that's basically because the judge had to go, the judge via lawyer, who is the judge and the lawyer, the same person, happens to be writing up our article of agreement. He had to go out of town unexpectedly for a few days, and he won't be back until Thursday. And so I got to wait till he gets back so that the seller and I can go in and sign all the final paperwork and whatnot. So we've already signed an original contract and made the down payments and all that kind of stuff. So we just have to go in and sign the finalization of everything and be all said and done so that we can turn it into the tax office and everything else and be good with it. So as soon as he gets back, we'll give you that update. And somebody was wanting to see a map of the property. I'm waiting for the surveyor. Showed me the map that he made. He's taking it over to the county clerk's office, and then I should get my copy any time now. I should get a copy, and when I get a copy, I will blur out the GPS coordinates and the address, of course, but then I'll show you the map. So
that way guests who want to come over have to ask first, so that Ralph can be prepared.
Yeah. All right. Where is Ralph anyway?
I think he was trying to sleep under the Jeep last time I saw him.
Here, Ralph.
No, he's playing in the stream, I think. Ralphie?
Okay. Anyways, time to go find our crazy white shepherd.
No, I put him in the Jeep. Never mind.
There's Ralphie in the Jeep.
He's so quiet when he's in there.
Such a good boy. There's Kyle Dog over there if you can
never
see him.
Never mind, Ralph. You're fine. Good boy.
Okay. Talk to you later.